You want to produce better parts. We all do. Nobody likes scrap. But sometimes finding a sweet spot between quality and efficiency feels impossible. Today we're talking about two big quality issues, profile and surface finish, and how you can pinpoint exactly what's pushing your parts out of spec.
Welcome to The Grinding Chronicles, presented by CDT Application Engineer, who we call the time-saving dynamo, also known as Blue Conrad.
Hi, I'm Blue Conrad, application engineer at CDT. In this video, we're going to look at how you can use data about your profile and surface finish to help set your dressing interval. Before we get started, let's quickly clarify these terms. When we say profile, we're talking about the overall macro shape, the geometry your grinding wheel is creating. On the other hand, finish refers to the micro-level surface texture, the roughness that you can't see with the naked eye. So how do you know whether it's the profile or the finish that's causing your trouble? Well, here's a simple and effective way to track it. Take measurements of your part's profile and surface finish at regular intervals. Every 5 or 10 parts is great. Then plot those results against the volume you've ground on a chart like this one. On this graph, the horizontal axis shows the volume ground in cubic inches per inch of wheel width. Vertically, you're tracking a profile measurement. Here we can see the profile goes out of spec at 14 parts. Then you will do the same for surface finish. Whichever one crosses the line first, that's your constraint. In this scenario, surface finish never went out of spec, but you'll need to dress to get the profile back in line every 14 parts. Through this analysis, you can be confident you are dressing your wheel at the right frequency and for the right reasons. Now that you know your dressing frequency, you may be looking for ways to improve it to get more life out of your wheel. If your profile is going out first, one possible cause is excessive force per grit, the amount of force on each individual cutting edge. That force increases when the wheel work contact length is reduced, meaning fewer grits are engaged and each one is doing more of the work. You may need a different grinding wheel to bring that force down. Often, you can't change the wheel size, but switching to a harder abrasive or a more durable bond can help slow profile deterioration. However, before investing in a new wheel, it's worth ruling out other factors, like insufficient coolant. If coolant isn't directed properly, it can accelerate wear and cause the wheel to break down too quickly. For more on coolant application, check out episode 3 of the Grinding Chronicles. The reality is, you're going to lose profile eventually. It's not a matter of if, but when. The goal is to increase your parts per dress and keep your process running efficiently longer. On the other hand, surface finish may be your issue. In part 2 of this video, we'll dig deeper into surface finish and show you how you can predict it using a helpful calculation. Then you'll learn exactly which settings you can adjust to improve your results. Either way, by clearly identifying what's pushing your parts out of spec, you're already one step closer to finding a workable solution. If you want some help figuring out what's limiting your process, reach out anytime at thegrindingchronicles@cdtusa.net.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, follow, and subscribe button, and get ready to learn something new in another episode from Continental Diamond Tool.